Hey, how you doing? My name is Brandon Ennis. I'm a graduate of the University of the District of Columbia. I am currently a student at ISSA in the process of getting my certification in personal training and strength and conditioning.
Hi, my name is Kareem Malcolm, and I'm a former point guard for the University of Guelph.
Kareem is currently playing in men's leagues yearly, so he wants to stay in playing shape. Therefore, I'm going to put him through an off-season workout consisting of weight training, plyometrics, and speed and agility. All these are important for a basketball player. The reason why is because basketball is a physical sport, so therefore the player has to be strong, which is why we're doing weight training. Also, speed and agility is important for running up and down the court, left and right, lateral movement. That's why we're doing the speed and agility. And basketball consists of a lot of jumping, and that's why plyometrics is needed. Just like any training program, you have to start off with a warm-up. Our warm-up will consist of exercises that will be done on the length of the basketball court. First, we're going to start off with a light jog just to get the blood flowing up and down. Next will be high knees, really get the legs up, pulling the legs up, get them nice and high. Hip level, nice and high to half court. Then once he gets to half court, he's going to jog it down. Then when he's coming back, he'll do high knees again, coming to half court, then jog it back. Next exercise will be butt kicks. Really want to bring the heels up to the butt as he's running. Really stretch out the quadriceps. Do that to half court, and then jog it out to the other end of the court, and then repeat on the other side. Next exercise will be karaoke's. Karaoke's is more of a hip exercise. It's very important in basketball to have really loose hips due to a lot of lateral movement. So the way karaoke works, step the front foot forward, and step the other foot outside, step the next foot to the side, really open up the hips. You'll do that going one, same facing one direction, go one way and come back. Next exercise, slow defensive slides. You really want to get the legs used to being in a defensive position. So really staying low, hands out, toes pointing, slide each way. And then the next exercise will be a lunge twist. The lunge twist will, consists of is hands on the hips, stepping out into a lunge. So Kareem will be in a lunge position, and as he's in that position, he will turn his body in the direction of whichever foot is in front, and then just take the next foot forward and repeat on the same side. And then to end it off, we will finish off with walking toe touches. Walking toe touches, he'll have his hands out. As he's walking, he's kicking his foot up, keeping his leg straight, trying to get his toe to his hands, really stretching out the hamstrings.
Yeah.
All right, beginning of our speed and agility section, we start off with jump ropes. What this helps with is foot reaction and foot speed. The quicker you move, the quicker you'll be able to react and the faster your foot speed will be. What I'll have Kareem do is he'll have a set of 100 for each set of 10. He'll go 2 feet together, then he'll alternate with one foot at a time. The next part of speed and agility exercise is the ladder exercise. This will help Kareem with coordination and quickness. He will do 3 different types of ladder exercises to confuse his feet and to teach him to move his feet in different types of directions. The next exercise is the harness run. The harness run is where I will be wearing a harness and the other end will be strapped to Kareem's waist. This will help build quadricep power and running speed. This will help him build up better speed and acceleration running on the course. All right, this next exercise we're gonna do is called suicides. Suicides is also a bit of a conditioning drill with the speed and agility. What I'll have Kareem do is he's gonna run full speed to the free throw line, run back to the next to the half court line, back, the opposite free throw line, back, to the opposite end of the court and back, and he has to complete all this within 30 seconds. So it's a bit of a time trial as well. So that's gonna help him really push himself and try to finish the workout in within 30 seconds, and he'll do 3 sets of that. This last exercise for the speed and agility is a back pedal and defensive slide exercise with the harness. With this exercise, what Kareem will do is he'll do a series of back pedaling and defensive slides down the court. What he'll be wearing is a harness again, so it'll help with resistance. This will help build quadricep power and glute power, a lot of strength in the legs. It'll help him build speed while moving laterally and while moving backward. To start off with our weight training exercises, we are going to start with the bench press. Bench press works on pectoralis major, anterior deltoids, and the biceps, but the main focus is the chest. To complete a full rep, Kareem will take the bar off the rack, start all the way, arms fully extended, bring it all the way down to his chest, and all the way back up to complete one rep. He will do 4 sets of 8 to 10 reps. The next exercise is the leg press. Kareem will be sitting in a chair, elevated with his legs up. We'll push against a platform with the weights, and he will extend his legs all the way up, back down to about 90 degrees. This exercise works on the quadriceps, hamstrings, and glutes. He will do 4 sets of 10 to 12 reps. The next one is another leg exercise. It's a squats, similar to the leg press. It works on the glutes, works on the quadriceps and the hamstrings. This one also works a little bit on the lower back. The difference with this one is he will have free weight, so it's no machine. So he's controlling the entire bar. With this exercise, he will also do 8 to 10 reps, 4 sets. The next exercise is a shoulder press with the dumbbells. This works on majorly on the deltoids, also works on the traps and a bit of the back. Kareem will hold the dumbbells about head level, bring it all the way up, come back down at about 90 degrees, and repeat. He will do 3 sets of 10. The next exercise is a bit of a lower body exercise, the Romanian deadlift. He will do 3 sets of 10. This exercise works on the lower back and also the hamstrings. Kareem will hold a bar, one hand facing up, one hand facing down. Lift with his legs, back stays straight the entire exercise. He will keep his legs straight as well. He'll bring the bar all the way down while keeping his back straight. Bring the bar as low as possible, then bring it back up, standing straight up, and pushing his hips forward. The next exercise is a seated row. This is a back exercise, works the entire back. Latissimus dorsi, traps. This also works a bit of the biceps and the arms. With this exercise, we really want to emphasize keeping the back straight and in a straight line. Kareem will bring the cable all the way out, arms straight, without touching the weights. Bring it all the way to his chest. Really want to emphasize flexing his back muscles to really work all of the back muscles that he can. Then bring it back out. He will do 3 sets of 8 to 10 reps. The next upper body exercise are wide grip pull-ups. This will help work on the latissimus dorsi, deltoids, biceps. This is all body weight. Kareem will extend all the way down, pull his body all the way up as high as he can, and repeat this for 10 reps of 3 sets. The next exercise is a core workout. It'll be 4 sets of 25 reps. It'll be a series of different ab workouts. First, we're gonna start with a balanced in and out set. So what's gonna happen, Kareem will rest his hands by his glutes, find the flat part of his bum, get in the balance, feet together, in and out. The next one is crunches, and it's a simple crunch. Lay down on his back,
hands behind your head, feet crossed, knees to elbows to knees, flexing the entire core.
The next set is bicycles. Also, that one is balanced to really work the core. Again, hands at the side, feet up, into a bicycle motion. And then the last one is a Mason twist with a medicine ball. You have a medicine ball, feet up and balanced, bringing it side to side, working the obliques and the abdominals. start off with our plyometrics. We will start with the box jump. Box jump works with exploding, vertical, and this ability just to jump higher overall. So instead of a chair, Kareem will be using a box. He will have his legs on shoulder width apart, squat down, and come up. He'll land softly on his heels and keep his legs at a 90 degree angle and jump off nice and carefully. The next exercise is a dumbbell lunge. This will isolate one leg at a time to really work on those muscles in the quads, hamstring, and glutes. So the way it works is you have two dumbbells set about shoulder width apart. You're gonna step out about as far as you can, not too far though. And next, you're gonna squat down, have your legs at a 90 degree angle, push yourself back up. You really wanna push on your heels to really give a lot of power coming from your quads and your hamstrings. And then you're gonna repeat on the next side, push back. You're gonna do about 3 sets, 8 to 10 reps. The next exercise I will have him do is a squat jump. Squat jump, again, is a plyometric exercise. We're working on the quadriceps, hamstrings, and glutes. What's gonna happen is you're gonna take your legs a little bit wider than your shoulders. You're gonna come down into a squat, really push your butt back. Next thing you're gonna do, jump up, come right back down into that squat. We really wanna work on those quads and those hamstrings and those glutes. So it's gonna be about 4 sets for 15 reps. This next exercise is called a lunge jump. We're isolating the leg once again, each leg one at a time. So the way it starts off is you're gonna start off in a lunge position, really get down, get into that 90 degree, arms straight down, helping with your momentum. As you're going up, you bring your arms back, swing up in the air, you switch your legs, come back down into that lunge position. You're gonna do 3 sets of 10 reps.
Work it, make it, do it, makes us harder, better, faster, stronger. Work it harder, make it better, do it faster, makes us stronger, more than ever.
Start off our cool down. We really want to take pressure off the feet and the knees. So what we're currently going to do is called elevated legs. He's going to lay on the ground like so. Next exercise. Next, what he's going to do is he's going to bring his feet up onto the wall and just relax. What this does is takes pressure off the feet and the knees, drains the blood back into the hips, and really relaxes the legs. Alright, following the elevated legs, Kareem will do a hip opener, really stretching out the hips and the IT band. So what he'll do is he'll bring his legs to a 90 degree angle, take his ankle and rest it against his knee and push against his other knee to really open up the hips and stretch out the IT band. He'll hold each side for 10 seconds and then repeat on the next side. Exercise is a squat stretch. Again, we're really emphasizing opening up the hips. So what he'll do is take the legs nice and wide, come down into a stretch, rest his arms on the inside of his knees and push them out. We really want to open up the hips and really get the blood flowing in and out. On the squat stretch, it'll be a wide leg wide straight leg stretch. So starting from the squat, he'll start here, bring his legs straight. All he's gonna do is bring his hands straight down, his head down. We really wanna stretch our hamstrings and the back of our knees to really loosen up the muscles. Exercise is a hip flexor stretch. What he's gonna do is we're gonna step out into about a lunge, but the back leg is gonna has to stay straight because we really wanna stretch out these legs. So come down, the front leg is bent, the right hand and the right leg, right hand and right knee meet. The left hand comes down to the floor, and we really wanna bring our back down, almost touching. We wanna bring our palm to the floor to really stretch out those hips. And then we're gonna repeat the same thing onto the next side, 10 seconds each. The next cool down is a simple toe touch. All we're gonna do is have our feet together, take our hands, keep our legs straight, bring it all the way down as far as we can go. If you can't touch your legs, just come down as far as you can. But if you could go further, try to reach your toes. We really wanna stretch the back of those legs and really open up those muscles and get the blood flowing. Stretch is a quadricep stretch. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna find our balance on one leg, grab our foot, bring our knees together. To help with our balance, it's good to keep our other hand out to balance our body out. We really wanna stretch out these quadriceps from working them, especially with the plyometrics and the lower body exercises. And we'll repeat the same thing on the other side. 10 seconds each one. Cool down is for our core. It's called the cobra stretch. So what's gonna happen, you're gonna come down into a cobra position, legs straight, hips down, and head up. We really wanna stretch out that core. It's gonna be, we're gonna do this twice. So first, hold it for 10 seconds. Then you're gonna come down, bring your chest to the floor. Then again, push back up for another 10 seconds. Following the cobra stretch, we're gonna go into a child pose. This is to really stretch out the shoulders. So from the cobra, bring your knees down and bring it back. I'm gonna bring your head down between the shoulders and really reach forward to really help stretch out those deltoids. Next, we're gonna do a downward dog to really stretch out those back of the legs again and also shoulders. So from here, we're coming up onto our toes, pushing back, head between our shoulders, legs straight. Really stretch out the back of our legs and also our deltoids. And to end off our cool down, we want to take two deep breaths. So legs shoulder width apart, hands down, a deep breath in, and then a deep breath out, and then repeat it again, the deep breath in, and then a deep breath out, and that's the end of our workout.